The freshly launched Xperia XZS and Xperia XZ Premium launched over at MWC 2017 boast Sony's new Motion Eye camera tech, which is a step up from the rather nifty tri-sensor tech found on the original XZ. We had a chance to go hands-on and here's our full camera review. Sony fans will probably be happy enough to hear that the camera UI hasn't changed up much at all for the Xperia XZ Premium and XZS. Once again, you have superior auto mode for capturing standard shots, plus a manual mode for pros. Flick up and down and you'll skip between those different modes, superior auto, manual, video, and of course those bonus camera features. That Exmo RS lens features a sensor that's 19% bigger than the XZ's, which hopefully will make for even brighter images in low light. And Sony's new predictive capture capabilities should be great for those essential action shots. Along with that tiny 0.2 second latency, the XZ Premium and the XZS can automatically detect fast moving objects and capture 4 photos instead of just the one. The phone will then choose the best result and present it for saving. However, one of the biggest new camera features is the super slow motion video capture mode built into the standard video UI. Slow-mo is of course a pretty standard smartphone camera feature these days, but the XZ Premium and XZS go a step beyond the competition with their rather ridiculous 960 frames per second capture. In comparison, the iPhone 7 and 7 Plus max out at just 240 frames per second at 720p resolution. The resultant footage is truly stunning, offering very smooth results indeed. Just check out this comparison footage of slow motion video shot on the Xperia XZS alongside that on the iPhone 7 Plus. However, the actual method of capture is a little awkward, as you have to tap the slow-mo button at the precise moment that you want the effect to take place. Once you're in video mode, tap the new super slow motion button above the on-screen shutter to enter the super slow-mo mode. Any footage you record will be at standard speed until you tap that button again, at which point a super quick burst of 960 frames per second footage is recorded. You'll need to be super exact though, as this slow-mo footage is only recorded for around a second in real time. When that's over, the phone returns to recording at standard speed. Sadly, there's no way to edit that slow-mo footage after it's actually been shot, presumably because recording at 960 frames per second over an extended period would take some ridiculous storage. So therefore, it's definitely reserved for those more special moments. Check out our hands-on reviews of Sony's new MWC 2017 phones over at recombu.com/mobile and here on Recombu's YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.